Welcome to the mix, everybody. We have a really great show for you tonight. You got rapper Young Baby Tate getting into the mix with us to talk about her viral song, I Am. And you know our girl Leah Henry is back for some more celebrity news. Now, our bro Romeo is working on a project right now, so he cannot be with us tonight. But as you all know, the show must go on. Now, Anton, your birthday was on Sunday, so you know we have to take a minute and wish my boy a very, very happy birthday. Ron, happy birthday. Okay, so go ahead.
Gracias, mami. Gracias, mami.
Yes.
Look at this shirt. Look at the shirt. You feeling yourself.
Yes. I am in Mexico. me amo papi peoples.
Oh, period.
Okay. I love it. That's what I was going to say. I saw that you're in Mexico or you went to Mexico. So we have to know, how is it?
Okay, first
or
of all,
how was it?
I love Mexico. I'm still in this spot, okay?
That's
I have not
where.
Left Mexico. I'm at this point, you can just say I'm Mexican. Like, I've been listening to Selena and all of that. Like, my trip has been nothing but amazing, incredible. I've done everything. I did parasailing, which was incredible. I was, like, in the sky with the fucking parachute. I never thought I would do that. I was scared but excited. But I said, it's my birthday, so why not? I jet skied. Today, I went on a boat. Like, I've done everything. And it's so crazy because this year, my birthday fell on Easter. And, you know, I'm very spiritual. And so I just felt as though I needed to be with myself this year. I wanted to connect back to myself. And Easter represents, you know, rebirth, resurrection, newness. So I knew that if I wanted to manifest everything this year that I've always wanted, I had to connect back to the center and get back to me. So I had my Eat, Pray, Love moment. I've been eating amazing Mexican food. I've been praying and manifesting and getting everything I want. And then I've been loving on me. I've been loving hard on me. So, you know, I've been having my nipples out every day. You know what I'm saying?
Like, yes, it's the nipple. I love that.
You know what I mean?
When I went to Cabo, I literally drank margaritas and ate tacos the whole time I was there for like 5, 6, 7 days straight. So when I was watching your story, I was like, oh my God, this is bringing me back to one of the most fun times I ever had on a trip. You're living it up. Seriously.
My thing is different. I'm looking at Anton's story like, I cannot wait to be able to do that. Like, go out, have a trip for my birthday, have a little drink on the beach. Sorry to my parents. But hey, listen, I don't know if y'all saw his story, but I'm living through it.
Well, this is the thing. Like, I literally realized, I wish somebody would have told me that traveling by yourself is the best thing in the world to do. I don't have to wait for anybody else.
Girl,
I can
I'm not.
Do whatever I want to do.
You don't have like a boo thing or nothing there with you?
I'm by myself. I came by myself.
This is you better than
love
me.
Moment. This is like my spiritual come to Jesus moment. Like, it's all me, only my energy. And it's been incredible because I needed it. I really
I can feel that. Yeah, it's like I kind of want to try it.
Yeah.
I feel like your trip has made me realize I didn't take enough videos on my trip. And like, yours is looking way more fun than mine. And I don't like it.
You know what though? I felt like I was living through yours. I was jealous about your trip. I was like, okay, well, if she doing it like that, let me see what I can do. Shoot.
Okay, well, listen, you guys, I'm gonna go to Vegas in June because my birthday's in June. So y'all can live through my story when I'm gambling.
Yes.
I cannot wait. Oh, Jazz, I
didn't know Jazz about to show out. And can
can
we just pause the show? And just say, damn, Jazz, you look good.
We have to keep talking about this. Like it's a
oh
look.
My God, you got this like great sex glow about
you. Oh, God. No,
it's the sex glow.
I felt horrible last episode because my allergies were cutting up. So I woke up today. I was like, oh my God, I'm in a much better mood. Get to see my co-host. We got Young Baby Tate on with us. I was like, you know what? I'm going to put it on today. I'm going to show him what's up.
And she showed up and showed out.
Yes.
Okay, guys, listen. Anton, you know I love you. I'm excited to watch Jazz's story, but we have to get into this topic because I need to talk about it. So I don't know if all of y'all saw, but this weekend featured some of the best Final Four games in NCAA basketball tournament history, let me tell you. And congratulations to Baylor because they won the national championship for men. And huge congratulations to Stanford because they took it home for the women. First of all, round of applause for those teams. Y'all did that. And last year, as you guys may or may not know, March Madness was actually canceled because of COVID. And even this season, a lot of players decided to sit this tournament out for health and safety reasons, which I think we all can agree obviously makes sense. But I want to commend that the brave players that were like, you know what? Yes, COVID is important, but also I really want to play my sport and I want to show that I have school pride. And they did that and they left it all on the court while also giving us some entertaining ass games. Mm-hmm. And I want to shout out all my friends on the SoCal teams, UCLA, Cody Riley, Abe Eagle, please for Gonzaga. All y'all, love you.
Okay, I guess you're special, huh? You got these high friends in high places.
Yeah, right. Hold on. She said, okay, this person.
Right.
And we're just going to move on. It's fine. We can talk about it later. But I think it would have been dope to see some LA teams win because we have the Dodgers win their championship. We have the Lakers. And hopefully next year we'll have a SoCal champion for the NCAA tournament. Mark my words, I'm a Trojan, you know, fight on. But UCLA did the damn thing. And they could have won, but that buzzer beater by Jalen Suggs was insane. Did you guys
see it? Yeah, I watched it, but I watched the women's. I'm going to be honest, because I wanted Baylor to go all the way. I wanted Baylor to sick them, but unfortunately, Stanford got us with that one. But I want to know, do you guys think that the players should get some type of compensation for, you know, going out there and entertaining us, you know, absolutely, kind of putting their health on the sideline?
Absolutely.
Even for sure.
If it wasn't an issue, players should be getting paid because of the recognitions they bring these schools. Mm-hmm. Like their name becomes the face of these schools. They're bringing so much money, COVID or not. These players deserve to be paid for what they're doing.
That's what I was going to say, because I was actually a student athlete. This was before that we even knew what COVID was, before I even saw it coming. And, you know, it was crazy because you're on a team with some of the star athletes of the school, which is bringing the school all this funding. And when they're not on that court, I vividly remember some of the girls, you got $20, you got $10 trying to get some Chick-fil-A. There's no reason that your face is on billboards when you're entering the school, they selling your merchandise. And when you're not on the court, you can't even take a penny from anybody else, or you could get fined by the NCAA or kicked out. But you know, if your car breaks down, you can't get it fixed, but you're a star on campus. Right. I always thought that is not fair at all. And I feel like the players should be compensated, even if it's on an education-based level. Okay, keep your grades above a C and you get paid, because I always say, whether you're the star player or the bench player, you're still on the team. If I go work a 9-to-5, I don't care if I'm the best sales associate or the worst. I'm still making 10 an hour like the rest of y'all.
Period. Right.
So I feel like that definitely needs to be changed for our student athletes.
Jazz, I think like you maybe need to be on the board. No, like the committee.
I'm telling you, I'm like, Jazz is so well spoken on this topic. I love it. Like,
thing is, they, you know, when I was a student athlete, you guys know my mom, Tammy Roman, people didn't look at me as the regular student athlete. You know, even though I wasn't a showboater, I've always been very humble. They felt like we didn't have the same struggle, because I'm not asking $20 for no Chick-fil-A. You know, I have it where I'm looking at my peers and my teammates and I'm like, this isn't fair to you guys, because you're bringing so much funding into the school and the university. Our stadium. It was beautiful. Locker rooms, beautiful. Uniforms, beautiful. But it's like the girls were still struggling. So I would love, if they do a board or anything like that, I would love to be a part of it. Hey. But I don't know if they'll take me serious, but I would love to be a part of it.
Oh, maybe. You know,
since you mentioned the fact that you're a former college athlete yourself, I got to ask you, because I know that like on scholarships that students and athletes receive, there's, you know, a lot of strict rules on that. And you obviously come from a very, you know, famous family. So do you feel like you had to adopt a new style of living so you wouldn't get flagged?
Honestly, I didn't, because like I said, when I went on to campus, I wanted to keep a low profile. So I've never been the type of, you know, I was on TV, but it was like, I want to keep a low profile. If you don't know who I am, I ain't going to tell you, because I wanted to have a regular college life, just like everybody else. So no, I never had that issue. But when it comes to the strict guidelines of not being able to accept money from anybody or things of those nature, I never ran into that. But I know some of the girls would be tempted to, because it's like, I need a little change on the side, you know, of being on the court. And that's what they have to fix, for sure. It's really not fair. And I lived it firsthand. So they do need to change that.
You know, what they also need to change, though? They need to change how they treat women and men's teams. Because even in March Madness, you saw the weight rooms for women and men were drastically different. So I know we have to go to break, Zanik. I'm so sorry. But I also someone needs to look into how women's sports are treated just poorly compared to men's sports. Sorry, Zoe. Go for it.
No, you're good, girl. I wanted you to get all that out. But we are going to go to a quick break. But when we come back, Young Baby Tate will be getting into the mix with us right here on Fox Soul. And Amanda, once again, please stand up.
I'm going to have my nipples out, too.
Welcome back to the show, you guys. I am so excited for our first guest tonight, and I've had her song, I Am, on repeat all weekend. It's the new female empowerment song taking the internet by storm. So let's welcome Young Baby Tate into the mix with us.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so excited that you're on the show with us, because let me tell you, I Am has been my anthem this whole weekend. I've had it on repeat. And I feel like it's just, no problem. I feel like it's the song with affirmations for all of us to listen to over and over again. So I want to know, what inspired you to make a song like that?
You know, I was just getting into like a lot of affirmations myself, but every time I would look them up, like on YouTube, it was just so boring. Like, I am powerful, with this like mystic ass music in the background. Sure. And I was, it's not giving what it needs to give for me. So I wanted to make something that really resonated with me and something that I felt like I could say and be proud of saying and actually believe. So that's what I did. I ended up writing them down, like just in my notes, and went to the studio and was like, I really want to put this on a song, because I feel like other people should say it as well. Ooh. And so
I love it. Like, you're helping people, especially Black folks, because you know Black folks love your music, and you're helping them to just think beyond and to create what they want. And they probably don't even realize by singing the song that that's what they're doing. They're bringing in everything that they want in life. Thank you for that, sis. Appreciate
Now, I want to say that this song is going crazy on TikTok, and everyone from celebrities, influencers, to young kids are making videos using your song. So how does that feel for you?
It feels amazing. You know, it's not something that I necessarily expected when we made the song. I wasn't thinking like, oh my God, it's going to be a TikTok challenge and everybody's going to go crazy to it. I just was putting it out into the world. And so to see people really resonating with it so strongly, to the point where I've been able to be blessed enough to have like millions of streams on this song, just because of that alone, you know. So it's really dope, and I just feel blessed and grateful, honestly.
On this topic, I need to expose myself a little bit, because I was having such a bad day, like bawling my eyes out, scrolling through TikTok, and I heard that song, and I was like, okay, wait, let me go do my makeup, let me get it together. And that song really like just pulled me out, and I was like, first of all, remember who you are. And you can feel the song really making a difference, like emotionally, which is very rare for me personally. So I just wanted to say, like, that song helped me through a horrible, horrible day.
Yes.
I'm so grateful to hear that. You know, you do have to remind yourself like who you are. And that's really what that song was for me. I had gotten into a point where like, I kind of forgot who I was, you know, Corona, the quarantine was like getting everybody down. And I was like, wait a second, I am that bitch. Like, what's going on?
Yes, ma'am.
With all that being said, I want to know, what message are you hoping that people are getting out of the song?
Really just that the mind is so powerful, and we really are our own reality. And that words are spells. So, you know, just be mindful of the things that you say. For other artists, be mindful of the messages that you put out into the world. And just that, you know, you are powerful. You are a powerful being. Everybody is. You don't have to like have a degree to know how to speak yourself up, you know?
Yeah.
We got a wise one in the mix today,
Well, look, all of y'all know, and I've said this on the show many times, that I'm really big into spirituality and manifesting. And now to like hear a song that you are literally listening to affirmations like, I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am protected, well respected. It's just like it's beautiful. And I think a lot of people don't know, like you just said, that words are powerful and they actually can be spells. And the word I am is literally a word of God, and it is God. And I want y'all to read this. So I am is God. You are using the power of God to lead and cast something good or bad over your own life. So whenever you use the word I am, it is magnified and it's very powerful. So with that being said, I got to ask you, what are you hoping to manifest for your career?
I am hoping to manifest expansion, abundance. You know, there are so many different things that I want to do and so many different places I want to take my career, you know, just not in music, but outside of that. So that's what I'm manifesting. I'm manifesting love around me, surrounding me at all times, whether that's romantic or not. Manifesting that check, that bag.
Come on, that coin, that cheddar, that cheese. Is it true that one of your goals or something that you want to happen for your career is to host and perform on SNL?
That is true. That is very true. I've been wanting to do that since I was in high school. I went to a performing arts high school. So like, I just always have loved doing improv, and I think I'm really funny.
I love that.
But perfect. Like, it would be so perfect to be the host and the musical guest at the same time. Like, it would be like a little slight flex. And I just. Sure.
So, you know what I want to know? How did you end up signing and connecting with Issa Rae? Because that's major. And I love Issa Rae. So, how did that happen?
Same. I love Issa as well. So, I actually got invited to a writer's camp for the Insecure like soundtrack back in December of 2019. And from there, it was like a two-day camp. We were out there just writing, making music, making songs for the show. And the radio team was just very impressed with like my work ethic, the songs that I was making and all the things that I had done prior. And they were like, yo, we want to, you know, see what's up. And we ended up meeting Issa, I think, the next trip that I had out here to L.A., and yeah, she was just like, how can I help? I really feel like you're dope. Like, I want to help in some type of way. And we made it work.
Let me tell you, Issa is, I actually got the privilege and the honor to work with her on an episode of Insecure. And she's the most humble, one of the most talented people that I have ever met in my life. We love Issa over here. So you're blessed and lucky that you're signed to her label for sure.
Yeah. Very, very much so blessed.
Mm-hmm. I understand her, but I want to know the tea. I don't want you to hold out on me now. I want to know the first time you interacted with the paparazzi. Not like, oh, they were sweet. No. Give me
that. No. This story is hilarious. Okay, so this one time, this was 2019, and I had a show with Ash Nico in New York. And then I was flying out to LA like the next day to meet up with a label. And my hair was looking crazy because that night I just got so drunk, like so drunk to the point where like my manager couldn't call me in the morning after, like I was just dead to the world. So we're going to the airport and like, you know, you should probably like brush your hair or something. And I was like, what are you talking about? Like, why would I need to? I'm gonna go to sleep on the plane. Like, why would I need to do that? And he was like, we're going to LAX. Like, you never know who might see you there. And I'm like, nobody's gonna see me. Like, what are you talking about? Shut up. Oh my God, you're so annoying. So we get to LAX. We go to the driver And literally the second that we walk outside, I'm wearing some Betty Boop pajama pants, I Love New York shirt that I bought at the airport. My hair was a hot mess. And first thing I hear, Young Baby Tay, hi, it's TMZ. And I was like, are you kidding me?
Right.
Me, like, I felt like I had just jumped into a skit. Like, this cannot be real life. But yeah, I got caught out there. So now every time I go to the airport, I make sure I brush my hair.
Your manager from here on out, huh?
On certain things.
I haven't had the TMZ interaction yet, Young Baby Tate. But I've been to those gas station runs with the bonnet on, the slides, the looking a mess. And someone was just, can I get a picture? I'm like, how do you even know that this is me with this bonnet? Like, and I asked the girl that once and she said, I could tell from the eyes. I said, okay, no, at this point. But you know what I saw that I thought was really funny? On April Fool's, you tricked your fans and made them think that you got plastic surgery. So I want to know, were you surprised when people believed it?
Oh.
First of all, yes.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
I'm not a patient.
That people believed me, because if you look closely, like, the tub in the back is warped. It looks crazy.
Oh, okay.
So many people believed it. So many people were commenting like, oh my gosh, I thought you said that you would never get surgery. And I thought you said you would be natural forever. And I'm like, are y'all for real? Y'all don't see this? My mom was mad. My mom was like, I can't believe that you go and get surgery and not tell me. And then she was like, and then I realized that the tub was off. And then I was like, okay, but then I got mad because why is your ass out on Instagram?
Great for the emotions.
So do you think that this is still something that you stand by, to not get surgery as a female rapper in the game?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I feel like there's so much pressure on not just female rappers, but just on women in general to look a certain way. Like, you got to get the BBL, you got to get your boobs done, you got to have this like hourglass figure. And I just kind of have always wanted to be that person, to be an example that you don't have to do that. Not just for myself, but like for the other young girls that look up to me. To just say, like, you can be yourself and be as gorgeous as you want to be, as long as you believe in yourself. With, you could have no ass, you could be flat in the back, and don't nobody care, okay? At the end of the day, like, you are beautiful, then that's all that really matters. So, yeah,
I love that.
Heard you. Now, your album After the Rain is absolutely fire. So, we want to know, as a collective, are you working on any new music?
Yes, I am. So I'm actually out a deluxe version of After the Rain very soon. It's really dope. There's going to be about 5 or 6 new songs. I'm going to be dropping a single very soon from that. And yes, no new music for something after that, but the deluxe is coming very soon.
Yeah. We love a deluxe. She's not playing with the deluxe.
Right, and we just got the exclusive from the mix. We always get the exclusives, okay? She will be dropping new music, baby. Come on.
And you know, the deluxe always has some features. So I want to know, are we going to get some features with other female rappers? I know you had I Am with Flo Milli. I thought that was really dope. So are we getting any other ones from you on that deluxe?
Unfortunately, no. There will be no other.
We'll take it. We'll still take it. We'll still take it.
All right, you guys. Well, on that note, we do have to take a quick break, but Young Baby Tate is going to be sticking around with us and giving her opinion on some of our topics. So keep it right here on Fox Soul.
Welcome back to the mix, guys. We are here with Young Baby Tate, and as you can see, it's a whole vibe in here. So, Tate, we like to have our guests, you know, join in on a few topics with us. So let's just get right into it. Okay, so the first topic I want to talk about is a meme that, you know, was very heavy on my heart, that I just had to repost it on my real page, not the close friends, you feel me? Mm-hmm. And Tate, I noticed that you reposted it as well, and it says, if he ain't chasing you like the cameraman on Maury, he's not the one. So ladies, my ladies first, real quick, because I just need to know, like, am I crazy or do we all want to be chased a little bit? Like, please let me know.
You have to chase me. You have to make me think that you want me. Otherwise, I'm going to run after somebody else. Like, if you're not running after me, then I'll go to the sidewalk because,
Here's my thing.
Oh, Jamie.
Here's my thing. Track, there's multiple people. So you're not the only one chasing. Let's be very real. So you slip up. Your teammates over there, I'm just saying, they're running. They're doing the dash. So I'm going to just let you know right now.
I agree, because what's that song? I need you to be a runner, be a track star.
Maybe I should let Anton go first before I say, because, you know, the girls are...
I don't know. Anton's about to stress everyone out, so...
The girls feel how I feel, so time.
Well, this is my thing. I feel like...
No, that was the wrong opening.
Right, like, what is your thing?
I got to keep it 100. I'm going to keep it a buck. I feel like when men chase women... Women always say, oh, he's corny, like he's all over me, like I need some space, like why he chasing on me. I think women, you say that you want to be chased, but I think really women love when a man don't really pay too much attention, because it makes you want that man even more.
I'm gonna stop you.
Okay.
Stop him.
Please, you gotta fix the Anton.
No, because
listen, guys, let's be very real. I'm still young, so I think it's fun sometimes to be like, oh my god, like, okay, we'll play a little back and forth. You feel me? As long as it's back and forth, though. I'm not a runner. I'm gonna tell y'all that right. I walk. I'm not running.
I walk.
Can't even do it. But there's a big difference between pacing and smothering, okay? Mm-hmm. So when women say like, oh, he's doing too much, that's when you didn't get the key back that I like you as well. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to get the go ahead to chase me. If I didn't do the pow run, then don't chase. It's weird. I'm scared.
I was gonna say that because there's a balance, Anton. It's like, I want you to chase me, but now when you get me, I feel like that's a part of dating. Part, because now when you get me back up a bit, now let me chase you. So it's kind of like a game to me. It is. It's kind of like cat and mouse. Okay, you got me now, but now let me be like, why he ain't texting me? Why he ain't calling me? Why?
Right.
So you got to know how to play it.
But Tate, let me ask you this, Tate. So if you got two men, right, that are possible people that could date, and they both are equally amazing, equally as sexy, the sex is great, whatever. So one is chasing you hard. The other is kind of playing this hard to get. I like you, but I don't want you to know how much I'm feeling you. Are you going to go for the guy who's chasing you hard, or are you going to go for the guy who's like, I don't know. She don't need to know if I'm feeling her like that. I ain't going to chase her like that because, you know.
So funny you asked that. I'm actually currently with someone who acts like number two, and they are cut off because I need
her, sis.
Like, I need to like me. Otherwise, I'm wasting my time. I'm wasting my energy. It's good poop 90-90. Like, it's a waste. So let me know that you like me. Otherwise, I'm going to go to the one that let me know that you did.
Okay, thank you. Okay, can I just say, I agree with my girls, with all my girls. I feel like, you know, in the beginning, I get what you're saying, Tom. Like, you know, we are probably going to go more towards the person who's like, oh, I really don't care that much. But when you're in a relationship with me, like, if this is going to work, I feel like we have to continue to, like, chase each other in a way. Like, if we argue, if I mess up, I need to be chasing you. Like, I need to be trying to make up with you. I can't just be like, oh, like, I don't care. Like, oh, it's whatever. We can break up today. And if you mess up with me, you need to be chasing me, or else, like, I can go be with somebody else.
Right.
Yep. So it got to be a balanced chase. We chasing each other.
Yeah. Right. Well, I want to be chased a little more, but
we can chase here we go. Here we go. See, I was trying to come with y'all and agree with y'all, and now you can completely go left.
Yeah, I'm gonna chase you too when I mess up, but like, you have to chase me more. Like, I'm the girl. I shouldn't have to do too much chasing.
Right. You know? Don't you overdo it. Cause I'm just like, all right, whatever. I'm not doing all that. You're not that important. I'm gonna just go to your homeboy.
Wait a minute, Jamie.
Don't think you understand how many of like my friends and people my age like do stuff like it's only if the guys like did something wrong and you're like revenge, you're like, fine, you wanted to act horribly, I'll go to it, the homeboys are always finer.
Gen Z is out here.
I'm trying to go to the college party with you, Jamie.
Okay, well, I want to switch it up a little bit and talk about the upcoming Double XL freshman class. So this year's list hasn't been revealed yet, but they have caught flack in the past for not featuring enough female rappers. However, more women are making the list. Now, this year, there are more than 15 women running for the 10th spot on the list, including our girl, Young Baby Tay. Congrats on that. That's dope. So, Tay, let me ask you first. Do you think that with the number of women in hip hop that's going on, this beautiful explosion of women coming to the scene, almost like back in the 90s when you saw all these female MCs come into the game, so that the ladies are finally getting the respect that they deserve in the game?
I don't fully think that we are finally getting the respect we deserve. I think right now we're getting the attention that we deserve, but there's still like a very long way to go before I feel like we're respected in the same ways as our male counterparts. Because there are things that when we do them, it causes an uproar. It's on CNN, and you know, we got the people talking about the WAP and they're mad. But when the guys swipe a credit card through an ass, like, nobody cares.
We didn't forget.
And I was gonna say, like, I feel that Double XL should have given the ladies, honestly, their own cover for so many years.
I was gonna say,
yeah, because if we be honest, we're running the game right now. Yep. The women are, you know, so we could have, how you said, it's 15 women competing for the spot.
Right.
They should have each gotten a spot, if we're being honest, because for years, they're always sprinkling us in on the Double XL covers. You know, it's two or three women here, but this is the year where we ran it. So yep. I would have liked it if we had our own issue in the magazine.
Good idea. Like, Double XL needs to get, I think that is such a good idea, because there are just some of us that are doing really well and making really great music. It's not like just oversaturated and everybody's mediocre. Everybody is really good. That would be dope. I think they should do that.
You know what I love too? The fact that, like, it feels so much like the 90s when all the women just show love to each other, and they like put each other up. They did features on each other's videos and songs. Like, I feel like we're in that same period now. In the beginning, like maybe 6-7 years ago, it didn't feel like that. It kind of felt like the two biggest female MCs were kind of going at each other, but now the two biggest are recording with each other and doing videos.
Well, 6-7 years ago, Anton, it was only Nicki, if we're being honest. 6-7 years ago, it was only Nicki.
Nicki and Cardi. Wasn't Cardi like coming up?
Cardi was seven years ago.
7 years.
Oh my God.
How many? Three, maybe four.
Yeah, that was like 4 years ago.
Cardi been hot for more than 3 years.
No, she has
four.
I think I'll give her four, but I do agree. It's like back in the day when Queen Latifah had UNITY with all the female rappers. Now you see a lot of female rappers picking the next one up instead of, you know, trying to keep them down. So Double XL, y'all do need to get on that, because we need an all-female cover.
Well, I hate to be the one. I don't know why I'm the one taking us into break over and over, because I'm just having so much fun. But we have to take a break. We definitely want to thank our girl Young Baby Tay for getting into the mix with us. I'm sad that you're leaving us, because we're about to talk about some more great topics. But make sure that you guys are streaming her song I Am and downloading her album After the Rain. And keep a lookout for the deluxe version of her album and new single coming out soon. Do not play with my girl. Please do not play with her. But we will be right back in the mix here on Foxhole.
Welcome back to the show. Now, y'all know it's my favorite part. Miss Leah Henry is coming back with Leah Lemonade, y'all.
Yeah.
Y'all love her just as much as we do. So let's just bring her right back into the mix. Leah, what do you have for us today?
Hey, Leah.
Hey, Miss Girl. Hey, Leah. What do you have for us today? I'm so excited.
What up, baby?
Listen, y'all, we got to get into everything that's trending right now. So let's jump right in. Sunday night, all roads led to the verses between the Isley Brothers and Earth, Wind & Fire with decades of hits spanning from the 50s to the 2000s. The verses was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to give the groups their flowers. From DJ D-Nice spinning classic sets to Steve Harvey hosting and maybe talking a little bit too much. Listen, the night was straight up magic. During the verses, people could be seen commenting on the fact that the classic songs were real music. And rapper Troy Ave even commented and said, this is when music had substance and topics. So do you guys think that music has lost its substance?
No.
Yeah. I must say yes. And I actually have a song with Troy Ave. So shout out to Troy. But I have to say yes, even when it comes to the R&B, with female R&B, I feel like they have that on lock, I must say. But with the male, I don't feel like it's the same anymore. When I was growing up, I had the Chris Brown, the Miguels, the John Legends, you know, the guys of that nature. I feel like it's kind of missing if it's not coming from Division or like Brent Faiyaz, I think his name is. So, and then you already know when it comes to rap, the substance is completely out of there. It's not really what's the focal point. So I can honestly agree. I feel like with R&B, we don't have that feel-good music anymore that we used to have.
I would definitely say there's a few artists out there like Brent Faiyaz, Giveon.
Giveon.
I heard he's good.
There's some good artists. Great. But I will say a lot of people get away with like mumble rap now. Like they can just mumble over a whole bar to fill space. And people are like, that's so hard. Like, do you guys like Corvette, hop in the... he literally mumbled the whole bar.
Yeah.
And people are like, oh, that, not saying the song's not good, but it's like he got away with mumbling a whole verse. And I feel like maybe a little bit before I was born, like it would not have like been able to slide. Honorable mention, I call them Fire, Earth, and like the other one, like not to be disrespectful. I know someone out there didn't know the name like I did. So I'm just giving a point to my co-host that I'm not alone.
I'm sorry, did you say fire and earth and the other one?
You were there. Yes, I did say that. And I stand by it because I'm
that's not okay.
I'm
at Black Barbecue Season 2.
I stand by it.
Family reunions, that's all they play. How do you not know the name?
We can get into that later. Leah,
I just want to say that as an R&B singer myself, I do not think that there is no substance anymore in the R&B lane of music. I do, however, believe that the sound is very different than it was like in the 70s, 80s, 90s, you know what I'm saying? Like you had real live instrumentation. You had subtleties in the lyrics. You know, it's definitely a different form of music now, but you got incredible artists like Bruno Mars who just put out that new tech that made you feel like you was in the goddamn
Silk Sonic or something
with your bell bottoms on and your afro and just feeling like groovy with a smoking a blunt, like, you know what I'm saying? You have artists who make you feel good and they give you that vibe. So I don't think that there's no substance.
I agree with you, Tom. I'm glad you said it because I really wanted to get that out, but I feel the same way.
Also have to consider the fact too that like just back then they said it a little bit different. Like it was a little more smooth, but like Freak Me Baby is still like a classic and that's all about sex. So I think it's just the way the articulation in what is being said. But we gotta move on though, because we gotta talk about the fact that this was not the only big topic from the verses. We gotta talk about how much of a zaddy Ron Isley was looking. But
he was
giving
daddy.
I mean, look at it. I mean, between the tailored suit, the fur coat, the lady eyelashes.
Hey.
So, I had to bring it to the mix. Who is y'all's old school celebrity crush?
Wait, who is calling the Isley zaddy? Who is calling them?
No, internet. Are you
kidding? Listen, I was on there too, Leah. He was definitely giving zaddy. Please do not play with him.
Okay.
He had that drip on. He had his whole like persona was like, yeah, play my song, man.
Yeah, that man is 79.
Right. It's a 13-year-old. So I just want to put it in perspective of how the ladies feeling about Ron Isley, okay? Shooters still shoot.
Shooters don't miss.
I want to know who's your like older celebrity crush?
So it's definitely Nasir Jones. I had to say his government.
Ooh. I'm done. why did she get the Jersey accent? His government.
That was a perfect one. You picked the best person, I think. Dang, I should have thought of him. Dang.
He's a zaddy. Like, he's a zaddy for sure.
It's definitely giving zaddy. All right, somebody else.
Who's yours, Anton?
You know what? I'm going to have to stay in the Fox family. I'm going to say Lisa Ray McCoy. Right there. If you after Players Club came out,
oh yeah,
she was on everybody's wall. It was her and Halle Berry. And for me,
I was just about
Lisa Ray was like the around the way girl. Like she seemed like the cool, beautiful. She looked like she eat right. She take care of her kids. She make her own money. Like, and you know what? I'm really upset by the fact that like I haven't been able to meet her, and she's you know a part of the Fox family. Cause she just like she smell like vanilla and like.
She does look like that.
Oh, man, that's
I think it's the. She
look better than half of these 20-year-old women. Okay.
Open that shirt up for Anton. Open that shirt up for.
Yeah, you know. Ooh,
Shoot or shoot. Shoot.
Lisa Ray, how you gonna act? How you gonna act?
And I heard she was about to create an OnlyFans.
Uh huh.
Oh.
What's
I love this.
No.
I cannot. I have yours.
Zoe, yeah, we got to know Zanika Jamie.
Okay, I'm just going to say, well, first let me say, I don't know, like, what he's doing with this, you know, rap career he's trying to start. Yeah. But I always love Idris Elba. Is it Elba or I love some Idris. Put him in a movie and I'm gonna watch it. Period. I'm not gonna not watch it. I gotta
Once again, Zanique's taste is all over.
Yeah, you know. Like,
oh my God. She go from Justin Bieber to Rick Ross to Idris Elba.
Yeah.
I like them all. I like them all.
Okay, Jamie.
Okay, Jamie. What about you?
Earth, Wind, and the other one.
I have two words: Michael Ealy. Case closed.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. That's a good one.
But can we forgive him after he threw the kids out the window? I don't know. We didn't forget that. We didn't forget that. I would not forget that.
Oh my God, I'm done. Okay, Leah, what we got some more? We got some more juicy topic.
Yeah, we got to get into this. LL Cool J is mine. All right, lastly.
Quiet.
Okay, lastly, we got to get to the Queen Mariah Carey. She is another celebrity, joined the vaccination cause. Mariah shared a video on social media of her getting her vaccine and even hitting some high notes in the process. Carey joins the likes of Viola Davis, Martha Stewart, Samuel L. Jackson, Tyler Perry, NeNe Leakes, Whoopi Goldberg, the Obamas, and many more in entertainment that have documented that they have indeed received the COVID-19 vaccine. How are you guys feeling about getting vaccinated? I'm not going to lie. I got my first one today.
What? Period. I got my first one 2 weeks ago.
Yes. That was me screaming getting it earlier today.
Y'all crazy.
Now, can I ask you?
Y'all crazy.
It's me and Jay. Yeah, I just want to ask y'all, like, what made y'all say, like, okay, I'm just going to go ahead and get it?
Right.
Everybody else getting it? They're creating hysteria. It's hysteria. One person gets it, then you see your favorite celebrity getting it. They talking about it. So now everybody feel like, oh, I'm going to get it. It's trendy. It's nothing but hysteria, but they won't get me. I need the vaccination. I need the vaccination facts first, and I want to see how people react to it. I can't jump on the bandwagon that quick. I can't.
Facts. I'm with you. Ain't gonna happen.
Me too, Jess. Me too. I'm not really trying to get the vaccine. Yeah,
baby,
no.
I'm right there with you.
Yeah, we're right here. Baby.
Yeah, it's okay. You know, I support y'all. If that's what y'all want to do, that's what y'all want to do. Yeah. But I've, you know, just already seeing the side effects you know, I don't want to, you know, that happened to me at all. Me, I don't know how to put it. I can't have no side effects, you know. And like Jazz said, I don't have enough information that I know like what's going on with that.
Do y'all think that there's a possibility that when these like political figures or these celebrities have this very public vaccination and they like post it, do you think that it could be nothing actually in there and they're just doing it to get paid, or they're just doing it and they don't really believe it?
Now that's a good question.
Yeah, I never even thought about that.
I never thought about that because I always felt like, well, they getting paid for promo just like we all do.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that's why I didn't believe it.
And celebrities do that stuff all the time. Yep. They fake like they drink stuff or they eat stuff or they use this product and they don't do it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. But I'm gonna DM Mariah.
We gotta go to break, Anton. You wanna take us to break?
Yes. Okay, y'all. We gotta go to break. Leah Henry, I thank you so much for coming in. We love you. This is my favorite part of the show. Yeah. Give us all the beautiful tea. We love you, sis. But y'all, we're locked. We got more of The Mix coming right up next.
Welcome back to The Mix. Now, before we go, we must send our prayers to DMX and his family. It's been reported that he suffered a heart attack after an overdose, and fans gather outside of White Plains Hospital to sing his songs and send prayers and support to him and his family. We love you, DMX, and we want you to get better and keep being the hip-hop living legend that you are.
Yes, absolutely, man. Prayers up for DMX. Mm-hmm. Y'all, we almost out of time, but we gotta thank Young Baby Tay. I love Young Baby Tay. Like, if I wasn't a fan before, like, she just made me rock with her even more. And we gotta thank Leah Henry, of course, our girl with the lemonade gossip for us, for getting into The Mix with us tonight. And also, listen, if you haven't already done this, make sure you're following us on IG at The Mix Foxo. It's easy, it's just The Mix Foxo for all the exclusive content and breaking pop culture news stories throughout the week. Thank y'all for watching. We appreciate it.
Yes.
Stay tuned for the Tammy Mac Late Show. But first, Foxo is going to save us some money, okay, with their special Foxo deals. So check it out. Okay. We'll see y'all next week. We love y'all.
Love y'all.